National oil companies, or NOCs, have always played a major role in the development of the global energy industry. As the industry changes with the shifting patterns of demand, cleaner fuels, and a focus on trading and new technologies, NOCs are evolving too. Oil demand growth in both Europe and the US peaked around 2005. Now the market's focus has shifted to emerging economies, particularly in Asia, where demand is growing fast. S&P Global Platts Analytics says oil demand will grow at over 1 million barrels a day each year in the next decade, with most of that growth coming from Asia. Traditionally, NOCs have channeled their crude into refineries to meet domestic growth. With relatively modest levels of domestic oil demand, however, NOCs' refining cover was limited. The plants themselves often lacked complex clean fuels technology. Now things are changing. Middle Eastern and Asian NOCs are thinking much more about strategic changes and how they refine process and optimize their output. And they're also laying the ground for a downstream transformation set to propel the region's key players to new competitive heights. Two-thirds of new refining capacity is being built in Asia over the next 5 years alone, according to the IEA. And that will add a wave of more than 9 million barrels a day to global downstream capacity. Cash-rich NOCs are also responding to the challenges of a carbon-constrained future by growing their petrochemical and trading footprints. Many NOCs have been building cutting-edge, export-orientated refineries close to their sources of production, first locally and more recently in Asia. Recently, both Rosneft and Saudi Aramco have shown interest in joint venture projects in Indonesia, for example. ADNOC, an NOC that pumps most of the UAE's 3 million barrels a day crude output, has been signing agreements with international oil companies, offering concessions and striking other deals to monetize its assets. It's spending $45 billion with partners to boost refining and petrochemical capacity in its industrial refining hub of Ruwais, where most of its operations are located. Then there's Saudi Aramco, whose hotly anticipated IPO was postponed last year for it to digest state-owned petrochemical giant SABIC in a merger. Outside the Middle East, Colombia's Ecopetrol, Malaysia's Petronas, and Mexico's Pemex are all NOCs that have become more IOC-like in their downstream operations. NOCs have also started to work around the limitations of their regional product markets by expanding their own commercial and trading operations. Aramco's trading arm, Aramco Trading Company, has been expanding fast, integrating all Aramco's global trade volumes while expanding into new markets, including the US. By 2020, Aramco's trading arm has said it expects an increase in oil trading volumes to 6 million barrels a day. That's up from around 4 million barrels a day currently. If achieved, that would make it the world's second biggest oil trader alone, behind Vitol, based on 2018 figures. As part of the downstream transformation, NOCs are forging new supply links by tying crude supplies to refining assets, leveraging their large infrastructure networks and taking advantage of changing global oil product flows. It remains to be seen if the successful transition from national champions to new global integrated oil and gas companies will play out for all NOCs. But the wave of planned refineries, petrochemical plants, and trading desks shows many are willing to try.